Welcome back to my channel. It is the end of August. I can't believe how time has been passing so quickly, and I feel like 2020 has been nothing but. These are all of the products that I've been loving throughout the whole month of August, and I hope you guys will enjoy it. Let's get started. I don't have that many things this month because I have been pretty much just using the same old things over and over and over again. So I'm just gonna first start with skincare. The first product that I want to talk about is Fenty Skin's Total Cleanser. I would say I was introduced to this mid-August and I have been loving it a lot. Honestly, out of the three products, I feel like the cleanser is the best one for me because I really love the texture of it. It feels like butter. I love the smell. It does have a bit of fragrance, doesn't irritate my dry and sensitive skin as well. I also have been loving the entire concept of it. The packaging is just so beautiful. It is kind of this twist up kind of form. Although I don't feel like it's the most hygienic because this is also the area where I put like my product like this. So this opening here is in contact with the toilet. So not the best in terms of hygiene, but it's really nice in terms of like just very easily twisting, squeezing, and then you get the product out. The product is also really nice and luxurious. It gets rid of my makeup really well. I think this is one of the best two-in-one like makeup remover plus cleanser kind of product that I've tried that really removes makeup effectively, but at the same time it doesn't dry out your skin. So I highly recommend it. I heard they are coming to Singapore Sephora in a few months time, but if you are thinking of where you can get it in the meantime, you can go to fentyskin.com. I have another makeup remover that I love. This is the Neutrogena Labs Hydrating Micellar Jelly Makeup Remover with 1% PHA and hyaluronic acid. This one is meant for dry and reactive skin. It says hydrate over here. I like to use this together with the facial cleanser that it comes with. Together, they're both really gentle on my skin. It doesn't leave my skin feeling squeaky clean or too dry. It's just really nice and soft after I wash it, and I am like halfway through. But I gotta say, this one, when it comes to removing mascara, it's not the best. So I still do recommend like going in with a dual face kind of oil-based makeup remover to remove your really stubborn makeup. The next product is this brand called Cellapy A Repair Plus. This is the cell treatment essence. I've been talking about this on my Instagram a lot. I'm so happy that this came into my life. Cellapy is a brand that has been formulated by dermatologists in South Korea, and this A Repair Plus line is the only one that I've tried, to be honest and to be fair, but it is meant for sensitive skin. My skin has been loving it a lot because every time I use this cell treatment essence, it feels like water, but it really calms my skin down. If you have a lot of redness, if you don't want to have any sort of ingredients that might potentially irritate your skin, I do highly recommend the A Repair Plus line. In particular, my favorite one from the entire line is the Cell Repair Essence. The texture is like water. I mean, it is an essence, but the essences that we're all very used to, right, are all mainly for brightening or clarifying. Not a lot of them are really targeting sensitive skin problems like this particular one, so which is why I like it. It has no smell at all. It feels really nice and refreshing in your skin, and I love to pair it together with my Skin Ink Tri-Light device because this is definitely water-based and I can use that device together with this. Lastly, I have this. This is the La Roche Posay Toleriane Ultra Dermallergo Serum. It's also really good for people with extremely dry and sensitive skin because this one helps to calm down your skin, calm down your redness. I feel like it's very hydrating, very easy to spread. It's also not too heavy but not too light at the same time. I highly recommend this to people with skin problems, like a weakened skin barrier that wants to build your skin barrier. This one is a really good one to try. Alright, now that we've got skincare out of the way, let's talk about makeup. For this month, I have been loving, and I'm so glad that this is finally here, the Laneige Neo Cushions. So both of them are so beautiful. They look like candy, they look like AirPods. Definitely the prettiest cushions I've ever seen in my life till date, because they're both like just so beautiful, lah, okay? So the green one is the matte version, the pink one is the glow version. The matte version is actually really nice. I wore this to USS with my girls and I did a wear test, check-ins of both of them on my Instagram, so go over there to check that one out if you're interested to get these cushions. I really love how both of them do not oxidize on my face. The matte one was super long-lasting and it really brightened my skin and stayed like that throughout the day, whereas for the glow one, it gave me a very nice nice, like radiant kind of look. The finish is not shifty. So even though it looks glowy, it looks very healthy, but at the same time, it's not sticky to the touch. So I do highly recommend it as well. It really depends on what you like, what kind of skin type you have. If you have dry skin, of course, the glow one will be really good because it has 5 times more moisturizing ingredients compared to their older counterpart. This one actually really did remain really nice and hydrated throughout the day. For oily skins, of course, you want to try the matte one. Even though this is not extremely matte, but what I like is that it's matte to the touch. Kind of glow from within kind of look with this. The only downside though is that you can't see which shade you are. You need to twist and look at the back of the cushion like this. I highly recommend both of them and they are super beautiful. Love it. This month, I don't know if I've talked about this before, but you guys will have seen me use this like all the time. This is the Etude Rose Wine Better Lips Talk Velvet in PK014. So this is the shade that I'm wearing on my lips today. I love the entire Better Lips Talk line. You guys already know that. I have been talking about them for years. This shade of pink is super beautiful. It's not too warm, it's not too cool. Just right neutral, but at the same time extremely brightening on your skin. I love the formula as well because it's velvet, so it's not shifty, it's not glossy, it's not sticky, but at the same time it's also not too matte because my lips have a lot of lip lines and this one does not accentuate that. And the best thing about it being semi-matte is that I can use it as an eyeshadow or as a blush as well. If I can only choose one lipstick to grab and carry in my tiny purse, it will always be this. Next up, I have an eyeliner. This one is Marc Jacobs Fine Liner Ultra Skinny Gel Eye Crayon. A really nice like dark chocolatey brown color. Extremely creamy, very opaque. I don't actually need to go in like double times or triple times. Just one swipe is all you need. And I just love the tip of it. It's like very thin and very, very precise. It really does not budge. So it lasts throughout the day. So I applied it over my liquid liner to kind of soften it. I don't know if you guys can see the effect that I'm trying to go for, but the front part is actually using this eyeliner. One eyeshadow palette that I want to introduce to you guys today, it is this! This is the Vdivov The Palette Eye Color Bag in the shade 03 Electric Eyes. When I think about eyeshadows, I don't think about Vdivov. And Vdivov is a brand that you can find under The Face Shop. If you want to shop Vdivov product, you can go to any The Face Shop stores and you'll be able to find them. And this one comes in a cute little bag like this. It's like super beautiful. Dun, dun, dun. Look at the shades! So what really drew me to this palette is the shade of yellow. Honestly, I don't see any like yellow color in any eyeshadow palettes unless it's a really bold and crazy colors kind of eyeshadow palette. It's not only just warm tones that you see at the bottom, but you also have your cooler tones, you have your coppers, you have your mauves, you have your pinks, you have your corals, you have your oranges. Pigmentation of this is also really good. It's very easy to blend, very buttery, very flattering on the eyes, and that's also what I'm using today. This shade, and the glitter. And the glitter, I tell you, is so beautiful. So this is that glitter. A little bit of glitter chunks inside, but what I like about it is that once you kind of push it out, you get a very nice wet look. So it looks almost like you have water on your face. It's not like the usual glitters that you see. I highly recommend it. Lastly, I have two makeup tools. So this one is the Sigma Prackt Highlighter Brush. I really love the size of it. It is not too big compared to a normal blush brush. This is my beautiful angled blush brush where I go like this, but this is kind of like half the size, right? And I like it that it's dome shaped. It has a nice little tip, but at the same time, if I were to press it down, I get quite a nice grip because it is so loosely packed. I get to diffuse my blush or my highlighter. I've been using it and enjoying it a lot. Next up, I have here my Uemura Petal 55 Sponge. If you are a sponge lover, like if you like to apply your makeup base with sponges, this one is actually really, really good. What I like about this is it really gives you a very even thin layer coverage, especially for people who like that no makeup makeup look or for people who want to really slowly build up the layers of your foundation. Try something like this. Sponge of it is really thick. as you can see, can push it down really, really hard. But because it is shaped like this, you can drag it down like this. So instead of always having to only pat in, you can kind of like just drag it across your skin and you get a very nice, no makeup makeup kind of effect with this sponge. I gotta say though, this sponge definitely does suck up a lot of product. You probably have to use twice the amount of base makeup if you want the same kind of coverage as compared to using a brush or a silicone blender. That's the beauty of it, you know, it slowly kind of dispenses the product whenever you need. And it's super simple to wash. All you have to do is just like pull it out, wash it like usual, and then pop it back in. Yeah, that's it. Last but not least, we have my Gentle Monster shades. I've been loving them. So these ones were worn by the people in Itaewon class, and I love how big it is. Like, once I wear it, right? Do you think I just look extra expensive? I don't know. Okay, number one, I look extra bitchy if I don't smile. It might be a little bit too big for my face, to be very honest. It's already out of my face and it covers almost the entire eye. But I like that it's really huge, number one, and the shape of it is just really beautiful. It's also matte black, very opaque as well, in the sense you can't even see like my eyes from the outside. The quality of Gentle Monster shades are just extremely good. Sun protection is also really powerful. I like that it's also really clean. Don't have all of the hinges and everything. It's all kind of hidden at the back. So from the front, you only see two dots. That's it. You don't even see any like attachments. You don't see any breaking. One flat piece like that. And it goes well with everything. And I like black shades for its very chic kind of look. Usually if I want to go for something more casual, I'll go in with tortoise shell or something that is more tinted where you can see my eyes. But if I want something that is like really like sleek and cool, I'll go with something like this. That's it for me. I hope you guys are enjoying your month of September. Staying safe, staying indoors as well. Do let me know in the comments box down below what are some of the things you've been enjoying throughout the entire month of August. I would love to know and I would love to check them out as well. I'll see you in my next one. Bye!